I've listened to my colleague from Michigan, who comes here almost alone, and I think those who vote no, when they go back home, are really going to find themselves basically alone. Because those who vote no have no place to hide. This is an emergency for 1.7 million people and their families right now. Therefore, it's an emergency for the community of the United States of America. And that 1.7 million will grow and grow under this banner that is floated by the minority. Look, the excuses fall of their own lack of weight. You say we did nothing on the Democratic side. Yes, we passed a bill that extended unemployment insurance. They could not find a single Republican in the Senate to vote for that bill. And so you finger point at those who acted and excuse those who refuse to act, and you bring up the deficit, a deficit that grew under the previous administration. You can't hide behind that. This is an emergency. You can't hide behind the Republican bill either, because as I understand it, it was for 1 month paid for, and that month is gone. You have not come up with any responsible, feasible way to excuse inaction. Unemployment insurance was extended many times under Republican presidents, so you don't even have that excuse. When there was...
making the comments.
Okay.
Gentleman's recognized.
There's no excuse. And so what was done under previous administrations, Republican and Democratic, should be done right today. I'm afraid you don't see that there's an emergency for the families, soon to be 2 million. And also, let me say, in terms of economic growth, when you provide unemployment insurance to people, they spend it. So if you're worried about growth and consumer demand, put money in the pockets of people who are desperate, who are out of work, who are looking for work. Instead, you turn your back on them. I want to read a story. I met this person in Hazel Park, Michigan last weekend. He served 3 years and 9 months in the U.S. Army, including a year tour in Iraq. He has an associate's degree from a community college and a bachelor's degree. He was employed by a loan company, a mortgage company, as a broker, and then the mortgage crisis came and he was laid off. He was unemployed for 3 months and then he was hired by Kmart as an assistant store manager. He was laid off in August 2009 due to store closing. He has currently approximately 4 weeks left on his Tier 1 extension due to expire on July 14. There are 1.7 million people like this gentleman already in this country. I don't know how you look them in the face. I don't know how you explain a no vote. I think the flimsy arguments that are used won't work in this hall and won't work back home. This is an emergency. I really can't believe that people from the minority are going to come here and vote no. They're voting no for millions. I think they're voting no for what is best in the United States of America. We are a community of people. When people lose their jobs and can't find them, we don't stand and simply stand idly by. This is the time for you to stand up, and the only way to stand up is to vote yes. I plead on behalf of the millions of people in this country out of work looking for jobs that you provide the unemployment insurance that they worked for that should be provided. Don't turn your backs on them. In the end, there will be no excuse. No excuse. No excuse. You back the balance of my time.